Good afternoon. This is Al. I'm the Applications and Service Manager at Electron Microscopy Sciences, and I'm going to show you how to set up and operate a pulsed carbon rod profile in the Q150 series coaters. Okay, so the first thing that we must do is prepare the carbon evaporator insert for rods, which you see right here. First thing we do is we blow off any extra carbon that might be stuck to it. The maximum rod length for this movable side, there's a movable side and a fixed side. The maximum length is 60 millimeters. It's a little tough to see here, unless I can get a white background to show you. But the maximum length is 60 millimeters. That's what you can fit into the machine if you remove the insert from the machine, which I prefer to do because it makes it much more comfortable to set it up. Then you're going to use one of these carbon rod shapers which came with your machine. There's a blue one and then there's a red one. The red one is preferred. It gives you a thinner cylindrical, what is called a spigot. I don't know why it's called that, but it's a smaller diameter. It's 1.4 millimeters in diameter. The overall rod diameter that you get with the system typically is 3 millimeters. So this shaves it down quite a lot. So then we have this real tiny little spigot on the end. Now this goes in the movable side. And for economical use, once they get short enough where you can't really introduce them in the rod sharpener and use them on the movable side, you can always move the smaller rods over to the non-movable side, which will accept those quite nicely. Actually, they can be even longer. So what I do is I am going to center it up using those two hex head screws as my center point. And the first thing I'll do with the appropriate size Allen key snake, it would have bit me. Just snug it down. What you have here is a 5 millimeter hex head Allen wrench. You can use something close in the English variety if you don't have a 5 millimeter hex key available. But basically on the movable side, I use this to set a 5 millimeter back set. So then you can push the rod forward till it touches, and then using your hex key, you can gently tighten down and then remove the hex key. And now this is spring loaded. So as your carbon burns at where they touch, basically you have an electrical circuit. So you pass high current through the rod, it burns under vacuum, sublimating carbon off onto your sample. So you want some ability to feed the carbon as it's being evaporated. And that's what this spring-loaded system does. And I set a 5 millimeter back set because that's about the maximum. So now we're ready to go back to the machine and set up a carbon rod pulsed profile. Okay, so on the top of the Q150 series, you have an upper and lower half of the arm. I have them already split, but they get put together by that latch, and it allows you to change inserts in between carbon rod, carbon cord, sputtering, metal evaporation, whatever accessories you have with it. So there's an O-ring here, and you always check and make sure that there's no little bits of carbon or dust or dirt on the O-ring, so you get a good seal. And then the inserts have a set screw which fits in that hole, giving you some orientation. So because of the carbon rod is a bit long, you will very gently insert that in that manner. Then you've got two locking screws which will hold it tight against the O-ring, and then we'll close the lid. Now inside we have the film thickness monitor. When you're doing pulsed cord, carbon rod, the film thickness monitor is just not able to measure that because it gets heat shocked. The crystal expands, changing its frequency at which it oscillates, and causes errors in readings. If you're doing other profiles or you're using the extended chamber, which you see on this machine over here, it is possible to employ the film thickness monitor for your process. So specimen stage, that is usually left at 60 millimeters above the floor of the chamber. And just for demonstration purposes, I have a piece of cover glass for a slide that we'll use as our substrate. And we will put the bell jar back in place. We'll close the lid. And now we'll look at the display. For that, I will turn the lights off and position the camera so you can see it really well. So this is not any different than any other Q series system with the plus display. This is essentially how the display comes up once you boot the system up, except I have a special password which allows me to do things that customers aren't allowed to do, as in shut off the safety interlocks and do service related items. But at any rate, the display is pretty much the same. Depending on your user level password, it will allow you to do certain things and disallow you to do other things. The Q series display is covered more fully in a different video. So what we're going to do is we're going to go directly to the recipes, and we're going to scroll down. Till we find I thought I made here it is, pulsed rod evaporation. So if you press the white arrow, it will show you what the current parameters are. Pulse rod evaporation is not a high degree accuracy coating. Depending on your pulse length, the number of pulses, the pulse current will determine how many different the different thicknesses are applied to your substrates. You can get very thin, you can get very thick also for those people that need it thick. It has three screens, You can get to them by moving it side to side or pressing the buttons down below. So hit the back arrow and now we're back to recipes. Now we will find that again. Excuse me, it's a little difficult to see from my angle. Okay, pulsed rod evaporation, you hit the green arrow, and you're up and running. So that was the shutter finding its home position. The high vacuum valve opened and the system is pumping. And we'll be back in a moment with the lights on. I'll leave the lights off, but I will zoom out a little bit to give you a little bit more broader view. So the system will now pump to high vacuum. The longer you let it pump, the better quality the carbon you achieve on your substrate. And this may take several tries for you to be able to get a reproducible thickness that you like by varying, again, the amount of current in the pulse, the number of pulses, the length of the pulses. All those factors contribute to the final thickness you end up. This is not an exact science. This is, we've been evaporating carbon rods for, well, I've been in the business for 40 years. It's good to put down carbon. But as I said, the amount of carbon varies probably plus or minus 10% or more. If you use the setup that I demonstrated with the insert and use a 5mm offset, put the same tension on the springs, you can get quite reproducible results. So this system is already in that short time, mid 5 to the minus 5 range, which is quite enough for a standard Q150 T system. This happens to be a V+. It's capable of 10 to the minus 6, but we're not going to wait that long. So it says that it's pumping down. It has a percent done. It's almost at 90% before it will let you actually run process. So we will pause for this time. Okay, the system has gone through its pumping cycle. It's currently at 2 to the minus 6 millibar. Elapsed time is about 30 minutes. It happens sooner than this, but I had a couple of other technical calls to answer. So I just sort of let it pump. So when it's ready, it will say over here on this side, it says continue or vent. You hit continue, and then the system will automatically ramp up to degas the carbon rods, and then it will let the vacuum recover for a certain number of seconds, and then it will evaporate the carbon. And I have it set to single pulse. It's outgas recovery. It's allowing all those gases given off by your carbon rod once it's heated time to get out of the vacuum system. It's also good to store your carbon rods in a desiccator. It keeps a lot of the water vapor out of them. because it is carbon. It does, and it's somewhat porous. It will suck up water vapor. So right now it's recovering the vacuum. It's 90% done, and once that is reached 100%, it will evaporate the carbon in a single pulse. You could have multiple pulses. And once that process is completed, it will tell you so. You press OK, and the system will slow down the turbo pump. And once the turbo pump has reached a certain speed, it will go ahead and start venting the chamber. And there we go, it's letting a little bit of nitrogen gas into the chamber at a time to gently slow the turbo down the rest of the way. Turbomolecular pumps generally spin at 60,000 RPM when they're at full speed, so we don't want to G-shock the pump. So process is done. You can remove your substrate. And what I'll do is I will take the camera off the tripod if I can. And you can see the carbon coat that we put down with a single pulse at that particular current. I would say that's probably 8 to 10 nanometers of carbon. And that's how you do pulse carbon. If you want it thinner, you do less time or less current. Or if you want it thicker, you do more current, more pulses, more time. And that's the complete process. And that's the machine telling you that it's vented fully and is ready for the next operation, which would be to either refurbish the evaporator here on the machine, but I generally like to take it off the machine to refurbish for the next sample. And that's what all I have for you today. So this is pulsed carbon rod evaporation in the Q150 series. Thank you for your attention.